Dear children, pleasant morning everyone. Students, in this video, you are going to see revision for term 2 English exam. Students, what you are going to see? You are going to see revision for term 2 English exam. Students, for this term 2 English exam, you are going to have lessons 6, 7, 8 and 9. Students, what are the lessons you are going to have? You are going to have lessons 6, 7, 8 and 9. Students, now let me give you revision on grammar part. Students, you are going to have grammar part from lessons 6, 7, 8 and 9. Now let me tell you the topics on grammar part. Look at the topics. Describing words from lesson 6. Describing words from lesson 6. Doing words. Doing words from lesson 7. Place words. Place words from lesson 8. Sentence. Sentence from lesson 9. So these are the grammar parts you are going to have for this term 2 English exam. Now, first let me give you revision on describing words from lesson 6. Look at the board. First, let us recall the definition for describing word. Students, do you all remember what are the describing words? D-E-S-C-R-I-B-I-N-G. Describing words. Describing words. Students, do you all remember what are the describing words? Let me tell you the definition for describing word. Look at the board. The words that tell us something more about the naming words are called as describing words. Students, what are the describing words? Let me repeat again. The words that tell us something more about the naming words are called as describing words. Students, describing words is nothing but the words which we are using to tell us some more information about the naming words are called as describing words. So, what are the describing words? Do you know? Yes, the naming words are names of person, place, animal or things. So, what are the naming words? Naming words are names of person, place, animal or things. Students, what are the describing words? Describing words are the words which we are used to tell us some extra information about the naming words are called as describing words. Students, for example, if you want to say something more information about any person, animal, bird or place, we can use some certain words. So the words which we are used to tell some more information about any person, place, animal or things, we can use describing words. So students, through this grammar part, you are going to learn how to describe a person, place, animal or thing. Look at the next sentence. We use describing words before the naming words. Again I read. We use describing words before the naming words. Students, we should always use the describing words before the naming words. Students, whenever we want to say something about any person, place, animal or things, we should always use the describing word before the naming words. We should always use the describing word before the naming word. For example, blue bag. Blue bag. Look at this example. Blue bag. Students, here which one is the naming word? Bag. Bag is the naming word. It is a name of thing. It is a name of thing. So bag is a naming word. So here I have described this bag with the help of describing word. Here which one is describing word? Blue. Blue is the describing word. Blue bag. So students, this is describing word. Blue is a describing word. Bag is a naming word. So here, how I have used this describing word? Before the naming word or after the naming word? Yes, before the naming word. Before the naming word, I have used this describing word. another word, we have to always use describing word before the naming words. For example, blue bag. Bag is the name of thing. Here the word blue. Blue is describing word. Look at the next one. These describing words are also called as adjectives. Again, I repeat. These describing words are also called as adjectives. 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 Children, these describing words can also be called as adjectives. These describing words also can be called in other word, that is adjectives. Students, are you clear? These describing words can also be called as adjectives. We can also call these describing words as adjectives. Students, to make you clear, let us break out this grammar part through some examples. Children, before going to see the examples for describing words, first let me tell you the usages of describing words. Students, look at the board. The words used for number, color, size, shape, look, taste, smell, sound, and feeling are called as describing words. Students, again I repeat. The words used for number, color, size, shape, look, taste, smell, sound, and feeling are called as describing words. So students, the words which we are used for describing number, color, size, shape, look, taste, smell, sound, and feeling are called as describing words. For example, two oranges. Students, here the word two tells us the number of oranges. Here the word two tells us the number of oranges. Students, here the word two is describing word, as it describes the number of oranges. As it describes the number of oranges. Students, look at the next example. Red apple. Red apple. Students, here the word red is describing word. Here the word red is describing word, as it describes the color of the apple. As it describes the color of the apple. Red apple. Students, what is the color of apple? The color of apple is red. Red apple. Students, here the word red is describing word, as it describes the color of the apple. Students, look at the next example. Big house. Big house. Students, here the word big tells us the size of the house. Students, here the word big tells us the size of this house. Students, if you want to describe the house, if it is huge in size, means we can describe it as big house. As big house. Students, listen carefully. If you want to describe a house, if it is big in size, means we can describe that house as big house. Big house. We can describe that house using describing word big house. Big house. Students, here the word big tells us the size of the house. Look at the next example. Round clock. Round clock. Students, if you want to describe a clock, if it is round in shape, if it is round in shape, means we can describe it using describing word round. Using describing word round. So for example, round clock. Round clock. Students, here the word round tells us the shape of the clock. Here the word round tells us the shape of the clock. Students, look at the next example. Pretty girl. Pretty girl. Students, here the word pretty is describing word, as it describes the look of the girl. As it describes the look of the girl. Students, if we want to describe a girl who looks very beautiful or pretty, you can describe that girl using describing word pretty or beautiful. So we can say pretty girl or beautiful girl. We can describe that girl using describing word. Georgie salty chips. So which one is describing word? Yes, salty is a describing word. So here the word salty tells us the taste of the chips. Here the word salty tells us the taste of the chips. Just look at the next example. Fresh flower. Fresh flower. So see which one is describing word? Yes, fresh is the describing word. So here the word fresh tells us the smell of the flower. The smell is the fragrance. Fragrance of the flower. So here the word fresh tells us the smell, fragrance of the flower. So if you want to describe the flower which fragrance or which smells very good, we can describe the flower using describing word fresh. Fresh flower. So look at the next example. Noisy children. Noisy children. So here the word noisy is a describing word. It tells us the sound. It tells us the sound of the children. Here the word noisy is a describing word. It tells us the sound. Sound of the children. So if we want to describe the children, those who make noisy, we can describe them as noisy children. We can describe them as noisy children. So is all clear? Listen carefully. If you want to describe the children, those who make noise, we can describe them by using the describing word noisy. Noisy children. So here the word noisy tells us the sound of the children. So look at the next example. Sad boy. Sad boy. So here the word sad tells us the feeling of the boy. Here the word sad tells us the feeling of the boy. So if you want to describe the boy who feels very sad, we can describe that boy using describing word sad. So is all clear? If you want to describe the boy who feels very sad, we can describe that boy using describing word sad. Sad boy. Sad boy. He feels sad. So this is what the examples for describing word. These are the usages of describing words. Let me recall this usage of describing word again. Look at the book carefully. The words used for number, color, size, shape, look, taste, smell, sound and feeling are called as describing words. For example, two oranges. Here the word two tells us the number of oranges. Here the word red, red apple. Here the word red tells us the color of the apple. Big house. Here the word big tells us the size of the house. Round clock. Here the word round tells us the shape of the clock. Pretty girl. Here the word pretty tells us the look of the girl. Salty chips. Here the word salty tells us the taste of the chips. Fresh flower. Here the word fresh tells us the smell or fragrance of the flower. Noisy children. Here the word noisy tells us the sound of the children. Sad boy. Here the word sad tells us the feeling of the boy. So students, the word which we are used for describing number of things, color, size, shape, look, taste, smell, sound and feeling are called as describing word. Students, as I told you in the beginning, we should always use the describing word before the naming words. Look at these examples. Here the words oranges, apple, house, clock, girl, ships, flower, children, boy. These are the naming words. So here in these examples, We have used describing words before the naming words. We have used these describing words before the naming words. Students, I hope you are understood what are the describing words and usage of describing words through these examples. Okay, students. Now let us do one exercise based on describing word. Look at the exercise.
Huge.
H-U-G-E. Huge. Now let me read Look at the examples. Red, long. Red, long. So it's red. What does this word refer? Red refers color. So do you think our hair in black color? Sorry, black color or red color? Black color. So definitely this answer will not be a right answer for this sentence. So here we have given red color. So we all know that hair will not be in red color. So definitely this answer will not be a right one. Look at the next example. Example choice. Long. Long. She has a dashed hair. Which one is the right answer? Red or long? Definitely red is the not right answer because red refers color. So we all know that hair is black in color. Hair is black in color. So what is the right answer for this sentence? Did you guess? Yes. Long. Long is the correct answer. Long refers size of the hair. She has a long hair. So which is the correct answer? Long. L-O-N-G. Long. She has a long hair. So look at the next sentence. The boy looks dashed. The boy looks dashed. The boy looks dashed. So here we are going to describe the look of the boy. Look at the choices for this sentence. The first one is one. One refers number. One refers number. So definitely this answer will not be the right one for this sentence. Why? Because in this sentence they have asked us to describe the look of the boy. Then how this answer will be the right one for this sentence? No, definitely this answer will not be the right one for this sentence. Because here the word one refers the numbers. So definitely this one will not be the right one for this sentence. Look at the next option. Happy. Happy. So happy refers feel, or else it also sometimes refers the look of the boy. So students, if you want to say about the boy who looks or feels very happy, we can describe him as the boy looks happy, or we can say happy boy. We can say happy boy. He is a happy boy, or we can describe him as the boy looks happy. So which one is the right answer for this sentence? Yes, happy is the right answer because the boy looks very happy. So which one is the right answer? Happy. H-A-P-P-Y, happy. H-A-P-P-Y, happy. Now let me read this sentence with correct answer. The boy looks happy. The boy looks happy. Children, that's all about this exercise. Children, I hope you all understood what are the describing words and how to use them through these examples and exercise. Children, in exam also, you can have describing words exercises like this. So they may ask to choose the correct describing words or circle the describing words. They can also write the describing words on your board for the given pictures. Okay, students, now let's move on to the next grammar part. Dear children, now let us recall this grammar part, place words. You have this grammar part, place words, in lesson 8, the magic cave. You have this grammar part, place words, in lesson 8, the magic cave. So, do you all remember what are the place words? Let me recall the definition for place words. Look at the board. The words that tell us about the place of persons, animals, or things are known as place words. Again, I repeat. Look at the board carefully. The words that tell us about the place of persons, animals, or things are known as place words. So, what are the place words? Place words means the words which is used to show the location of someone or something. So, what are the place words? The word which is used to show where person is, or where the animal is, or where
the thing is. So the words which we are used to tell the location of things are called as place words. So students, there are some place words which are used to show the location of the things or persons. Look at the place words. Here I have written some place words. They are in, on, under, near, behind, between, in front of. In, I, N, in, on, O, N, on, under, U, A, D, E, R, under, near, N, E, A, R, near, behind, B, E, H, I, N, D, behind, between, B, E, T, W, E, E, N, between, in front of, I, N, F, R, O, N, T, in front of, O, F, of, in front of. So these are the place words which we are using to show where person is or where an animal is or where the thing is. So what are the place words? Place words are the words which are used to tell the location of person, animal or things. So students, the place word also used to tell the relation between the two naming words. It also used to tell us the relation between the two naming words. Now let us recall this place words. Let us recall the usages of place words through some examples. Look at the first example. Are. So first let me tell you the example for place word are. Look at this example sentence. Yeah, cake is on the table. Again I read. Yeah, cake is on the table. Students, in this sentence, which one is place word? Yes, on is the place word. So here the place word on tells us the location of the cake. Here the place word on tells us the position of the cake. So this, where is the cake? Look at this picture. Where is the cake? The cake is on the table. The cake is on the table. So if you notice the picture carefully, you can see that the cake is placed on the table. The cake is placed on the table. So here the place word on tells us the location of the cake. So this, where is the cake? The cake is on the table. The cake is on the table. So here the place word on tells us the relation between the two things, a cake and table. So let's look at this picture carefully. Where is the cake? The cake is on the table. So here the place word on, it tells us to show where the cake is. To show where the cake is. So where is the cake? The cake is on the table. The cake is on the table. Look at the next example sentence using place word in. Look at the sentence. Juice is in the glass. Juice is in the glass. So where is juice? The juice is in the glass. The juice is in the glass. So here which one is place word? In. In is the place word. So here the place word in tells us the position of the juice. Here the place word in tells us the position of the juice. So where is the juice? The juice is inside the glass. The juice is inside the glass. So as the juice is placed inside the glass, to show where the juice is, we have used place word in. We have used place word in. Choose where is the juice? The juice is in the glass. Juice is in the glass. So here the place word in tells us where the juice is. The juice is placed inside the glass. So that's why we have used place word in to show where the juice is. Now let's move on to the next example sentence. Using place word under. U-N-D-E-R. E-R, anger. Look at the example sentence. An apple is under the table. An apple is under the table. So, where is apple? Look at this picture. Where is apple? The apple is placed under the table. The apple is placed under the table. Here, which one is place word? Under. Under is the place word. So, here the place word under tells us the position of the apple. Position of the apple. So, here the place word under, it is used to tell us where the apple is. So, where is the apple? The apple is placed under the table. The apple is placed under the table. So, to show where the apple is, we have used place word under. Look at the example sentence again. An apple is under the table. So, where is the apple? The apple is placed under the table. Look at the next example sentence. Near. N-E-A-R. Near. Look at the example sentence for using place word near. A floor is near the jet. A floor is near the jet. So, in this sentence, which one is place word? Yes, near. Near is the place word. N-E-A-R, near. So, here the place word near tells us the location of the flower. Where is the flower? The flower is near the jet. The flower is near the jet. So, here the place word tells us the relation between the two things. What are the two things you can see in this picture? One is flower and another one is jet. So, here the place word near tells us where the flower is. So, where is the flower? The flower is near the jet. The flower is near the jet. Look at the next example sentence using place word behind. B-E-H-I-N-D. Behind. Look at the sentence. The ball is behind the tree. The ball is behind the tree. So, where is the ball? The ball is placed behind. Behind the tree. So, in this sentence, which one is place word? Behind. Behind is the place word. So, here the place word behind tells us that where the ball is. So, where is the ball? The ball is behind the tree. So, as the ball is placed behind the tree, we have used place word behind to show where the ball is. To show where the ball is. So, where is the ball? Look at this picture. If you notice the picture carefully, you can see that the ball is placed behind the tree. The ball is placed behind the tree. Look at the example sentence again. The ball is behind the tree. Where is the ball? The ball is behind. The ball is behind the tree. Look at the next example sentence using place word between. B-E-T-W-E-E-N. Between. The cup is between. The cup is between the two balls. Again, I repeat. The cup is between the two balls. So, where is the cup? The cup is placed between the two balls. Where is the cup? The cup is placed between the two balls. So, here the place word between tells us the location of the cup. So, here the place word refers the location of the cup. So, where is the cup? The cup is placed between the two balls. So, here which one is place word? Between is the place word. So, here we have used place word between to show where the cup is. So, where is the cup? The cup is between. Between the two balls. The cup is placed between the two balls. Look at the next example sentence using place word in front of. I-N-A-F-R-O-N-T. Front of. O-F. Of. In front of. Look at this example sentence. The umbrella is in front of the chair. The umbrella is in front of the chair. So, look at this picture. Where is the umbrella? The umbrella is placed
of. In front of is a place word. So here the place word in front of tells us the relation between the two things, umbrella and chair. So here which one is place word? In front of is the place word. Here we have used this place word in front of to show where the umbrella is. Students, where is the umbrella? The umbrella is in front of the chair. The umbrella is in front of the chair. So this, what is the usage of place word? The place words are used to tell where someone or something is. The place words are used to tell us the location or position of the things. So this is what the place word. Now let us do one example exercise using place words. Exercise. First, look at the title of this exercise. Look at the pictures and choose the correct place words from the given box. Again, I read. Look at the pictures and choose the correct place words from the given box. So, in this exercise, what you have to do? First, you have to look at the location of this picture. First, what you have to do? First, you have to look at the location of this picture. Then you have to choose the correct place word from the given box, which is suitable to the given sentences. Students, are you clear? What we have to do in this exercise? First, you have to look at the location of the things in this picture. After that, you have to choose the correct place word from the given box, which is suitable to the given sentence. Now, shall we do the exercise? Yes, look at the first one. The book is dash the table. The book is dash the table. So now first we have to find out the location of the book using place word. So look at this picture carefully. Where is the book? Can you see that? Where is the book? Yes, the book is placed on the table. The book is placed on the table. Can you see that? Where is the book? Yes, the book is on the table. So which place word we have to use to show the location of the book? Which place word we have to use? Yes, we have to use place word on. The book is on the table. The book is on the table. So here the place word are, which is used to tell us the location of the book. So the place word on is the correct answer for this sentence. The book is on the table. So here the place word on tells us the location of the book. So where is the book? The book is on the table. Now let's move on to the next sentence. Look at the next sentence. The bird is dash the clouds. The bird is dash the clouds. So now we are going to find out the location of the bird. So where is the bird? Look at this picture carefully. Can you see the bird? Where is it? Yes, it is between the two clouds. It is between the two clouds. So which place would we have to use to show where the bird is? Which place would we have to use? Yes, we have to use place word between. B E T W E E N. Between. So we have to use place word between to show the location of the thing if it is placed between any two objects, two animals or two persons. Are you clear? Where we are supposed to use the place word between? We are supposed to use place word between to show the location of the thing if it is placed between any two objects, two persons or two animals. Are you clear? Where is the bird? The bird is between the clouds. The bird is between the clouds. For which one is the correct answer? Between. B The cat is dash the house. The cat is dash the house. So listen, now we are going to find out the location of the cat. Now we are going to find out the location of the cat. Children, where is the cat? Look at this picture. Where is the cat? Yes, the cat is inside the house. The cat is inside the house. So, which place word we have to use to show the location of the cat? Look at this box. So, already we have used place word on, and then we have used place word between. So, now we have remaining place words are in, under, near. So, among these place word, we have to find out the correct place word which is suitable to the given sentence. Friends, where is the cat? Can you tell the location of the cat? Where it is? It is inside the house. It is inside the house. So, children, if any person, animal or thing is placed inside anything, means which place word we have to use? We have to use place word in. We have to use place word in. So, which is the correct answer for this sentence? Yes, the place word in. The cat is in the house. The cat is in the house. Where is the cat? The cat is in the house. So, here the place word in tells us the location of the cat. Then, the ball is at the table. The ball is at the table. So, now we have to find out the location of the ball. So, where is the ball? Look at this picture. Where is the ball? Can you find out the location of the ball? Where is it? Yes, it is placed under the table. It is placed under the table. So, which place word we have to use to show the location of the ball? Yes, we have to use place word under. We have to use place word under. So, which one is the correct answer for this sentence? Under. U-N-D-E-R, under. So, here the place word under tells us the location of the ball. Now, let us move on to the next sentence. The tree is dash the house. The tree is dash the house. So, let's now look at this picture. Can you find out the location of the tree? Where is the tree? Yes, the tree is near the house. The tree is near the house. So, here the place word near tells us the position of this tree. So, where is the tree? The tree is near the house. The tree is near the house. So, this is how to do the exercise. So, if you have this exercise in your exam, first, what you have to do? First, you have to look at the pictures. First, you have to look at the location of the things. Then, you have to choose the correct place word from the given box, which is suitable to the given sentence. So, where we are supposed to use place word between? We are supposed to use place word between to show the location of the thing if it is placed between any two objects. To show the location of the thing if it is placed between two objects. This is where we are supposed to use place word between. To show the location of the thing if it is placed between any two objects. So that's all about place word. Now let us move on to the next example part. Let me recall the definition for sentence. What does mean by sentence? Look at the board. They are a group of words that make complete sense. What is sentence? They are a group of words that make complete sense. So, a sentence means it's nothing but a group of words joined together that will give us a complete meaning. That will give us a complete meaning is called a sentence. What does mean by sentence? Sentence means a group of words joined together that give us a complete meaning. Complete meaning is called a sentence. And I also told you that sentence has two parts. Sentence has two parts. So, how many parts are there in a sentence?
There are two parts. What are they? Naming part and telling part. So please listen carefully. Sentence has two parts. The one is naming part and another one is telling part. Students, if the sentence has naming part and telling part alone, it makes complete sense. It makes a complete sense. Otherwise, it will not make any sense. If a sentence do not have naming part or telling part, definitely it will not make any complete sense. Sentence has two parts. How many parts are there in a sentence? There are two parts in a sentence. The one is naming part and the another one is telling part. Students, first let me tell you what we can see in the naming part. Students, what we can see in the naming part to make sentence? Naming words. What you can see in the naming part? Naming words. For example, cat. C-A-T, cat. Cat is a naming word. What is that? Cat. Cat is a naming word. So that's the naming part. You can see naming word. In naming part, what you can see? The naming part, you can see naming word. Students, do you get any meaning out of this? Does it make any sense? Yes, we all know that cat is a naming word. Cat is a naming word. Cat is a name of animal. Cat is a name of animal. So, we all just know that cat is a naming word. But we do not have any complete idea about this cat. Why? If you want to get any complete idea about this cat, what do we need? What do we need? We need telling part. We need telling part to make complete sense. To make a sentence. To make sentence about this cat, we need telling part. Students, are you clear? We all have a naming part here. That is cat. Cat is a naming word. We all just know that cat is a naming word. It is the name of an animal. But we do not have any complete idea about this cat. Why? Because we do not have telling part. We do not have telling part. So students, without telling part, definitely this naming part will not make any sense. This word will not make any complete sentence. So, if you want to know about this cat, we should add some group of words. Are you clear? If you want to know about this cat, if you want to know more about this cat, definitely we should add a group of words. That is what telling part. So when we add telling part, definitely it will make complete sense. Now I am going to add a group of words to know more about this cat. For example, cat brings milk. Cat brings milk. So students, now we have added a group of words to know more about this cat. So in the beginning, we all just know that cat is a naming word. It comes under the naming part. But without, apart from that, we do not know anything about this cat. But when we added a telling part, when we added a group of words, we can come to know that what cat is doing. What cat is doing? It drinks milk. What does this cat do? It drinks milk. Students, in naming part, we can see a naming word. In telling part, we can see that what someone or something is doing. So when we have naming part and telling part alone, it makes complete sense. So here we have a naming part as well as telling part. Now we have got a sentence. Now we have got a sentence which makes complete sense. Which makes complete sense. Cat drinks milk. So that cat is a naming word. Drinks milk is a telling part. It comes under the telling part. So in the naming part we can see the naming word. In telling part we can see that what someone or something is doing. And as well as this telling part always begins with action word. Telling part always begins with action word. Students, you should remember that telling part always begins with action word. Telling part always begins with action word. So students, a sentence has two parts. A sentence has two parts. What are they? The one is naming part and another one is telling part. In naming part, what you can see? Naming words. In telling part, what you can see? A group of words. A group of words that makes complete sense to know more about this naming word. To know more about this naming word. Are you clear, students? What is sentence? Sentence is a group of words. Sentence is a group of words. What is sentence? Sentence is a group of words that join together, which makes a complete sense. Which makes a complete sense. Are you clear, students? About sentence. What is sentence? Sentence. Sentence is a group of words joined together that makes a complete meaning. That makes a complete sense or gives us a complete meaning. Definitely, if you want to write any sentence, it should have naming part and as well as telling part. In naming part, you can see a naming word, and telling part, you can see what someone or something is doing. And one more thing you should remember that telling part always should begin with action word. Telling part should always begin with action word. So here you all know that which one is action word? Drink. Drink is the action word. So what this cat does? What does this cat do? This cat drinks milk. This cat drinks milk. So as I told you, according to the rule of the grammar, telling part always should begin with action. Should begin with action word. So now we have got a full sentence that makes a complete sense. That is, cat drinks milk. Cat drinks milk. Students, now we all have recalled what is sentence and what are the parts of the sentence. And we also should recall the one more rule for writing a sentence. What is that? Did I miss anything about the sentence, about making a sentence? Did I miss anything? Yes, I have missed something here. What is that? Here, I want to recall you the rule of making a sentence, the one more rule. What is that? So, whenever you write any sentences, the sentence should begin with a capital letter and it should end with full stop. Full stop means a dot. What is full stop? A dot. Which gives us the sentence, which means that the sentence get over. The sentence get over or the sentence is complete. Okay. So is it clear what I am saying? Here the dot. The dot refers a full stop, which means that the sentence, the written sentence is completed. The written sentence is completed. Students, the one more rule for making a sentence is the first letter. First letter of the sentence should begin with capital letter. The first letter of the sentence should begin with capital letter and end with full stop. Are you clear? Students, whenever you write any sentences, the sentence should begin with capital letter and end with full stop. For example, Raj is buying fruits. Raj is buying fruits. So here, sentence begin with naming verb. This sentence begin with naming verb. So whenever you have a naming verb in the beginning of the sentence, you should always start that sentence with the capital letter. You should start that sentence with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. Students, you should always remember to write any sentences. We should always start the sentence with capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. And look at the next example. Geeta sings a song. Geeta sings a song. So here also we have a sentence that makes a complete sense. So here Geeta is a naming word. It is the beginning of the sentence. So whenever you write any sentences, first what you should do? You should begin the sentence with the capital letter and the end of the sentence with full stop. I have done. So only then that sentence may complete sense. Only then that sentence may complete sense. So what are things we have to do to make a sentence? First, we should write naming word. Then we have to write what someone or something is doing. So after that, what we have to do? Whenever you write any sentences, it should begin with the capital letter and end with the full stop. These are the rules you should follow whenever you write any sentences. So first you have to write the naming part, then you have to write the ending part. So after doing that, you should begin the sentence with the capital letter and the end of the sentence with full stop. And students, look at the next example. Aksa, Arun and Hari are friends. Listen carefully. Aksa, Arun and Hari are friends. Look at the sentence. Aksa, Arun and Hari are friends. Students, do you think this sentence gets or the sentence make any complete sense? Do you think the sentence make any complete sense? Is there any mistakes in the sentence? Can you guess? Did you find any mistakes out of this sentence? Did you guess? Yes, there are some mistakes in this sentence. The sentence did not give any complete sense. Why? Because the sentence is not followed by one rule. What is that? The sentence did not begin with the capital letter and end with the full stop. The sentence did not begin with the capital letter and end with the full stop. Students, I told you, know we have to follow some rules for writing any sentences. The first thing, a sentence should have a naming part and ending part. And the another rule is, it should begin with the capital letter and end with full stop. But here, we all have a group of words that make a complete sense. But the sentence did not begin with the capital letter and end with full stop. So we have to do that now. Whenever you write any sentences, you should start the sentence with capital letter. Aksha, Arun and Hari are friends. And we should end the sentence with full stop. We should end the sentence with full stop. And now also the sentence did not give any complete sense. I think the sentence did not give complete sense. Why is it so? Why? Here we have two more naming words. Here we have two more naming words. Students, in any sentences, when you come across one naming word or more than one naming word or more than two or three naming words, you should always begin the naming word with the capital letter. You should always begin the naming words with the capital letter. So here we have three naming words. So according to the rule of making sentence, we have started the sentence with the capital letter. So similarly, we should also start the naming word with the capital letter. We should start the naming words with the capital letter. Aksha. Aksha is the naming word. It is the name of a person. So whenever you write any names of a person, you should write it. You should start them with the capital letter. So here I have started this naming word with the capital letter. Aksha. Similarly, I should also start this naming word with the capital letter. Because Arun. Arun is a naming word. It is a name of a boy. So I should start this naming word with capital letter. Arun. A-R-U-N. Arun. Capital letter. And look at the next naming word. Aksha, Arun and Hari. Hari is also a naming word. So whenever you write any naming words, you should always start the naming word with capital letter. Now you see this sentence. This sentence make a complete sense because according to the rules of making sentence, the sentence begin with the capital letter and end with the full stop. So here we have come across with the three naming words. So whenever you come across with the two naming words or more than two naming words, you should start to write those naming words with the capital letter. So here you can see that Aksha, Arun and Hari are friends. Again, I rewrite the sentence with the correct answer here. Look at this. Aksha. Students, Aksha is the naming word. That's why I have started this naming word with a capital letter. Are you clear? Aksha is the naming word. That's why I have started this naming word with capital letter. Arun. Arun also is another naming word. So whenever you write naming word, you should begin with capital letter. Aksha, Arun and Hari. Hari is also another naming word. So as this word is a naming word, I have started this naming word with capital letter. Aksha, Arun and Hari are friends. Are friends. Now we have got a sentence that makes complete sense. And whenever you write sentence, you should begin the sentence with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. End the sentence with full stop. Full stop, which means the sentence is completed. The sentence get over. Are you clear, students? What is sentence? Sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. Sentence has two parts. One is naming part and another one is telling part. In naming part, you can see the naming words. In naming part, you can see naming words. In telling part, you can see that what someone or something is doing. And the one more rule is for writing a sentence is, whenever you write any sentences, the sentence should begin with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. Students, I hope you all have got clear idea about sentences. I hope you all understood what is sentence and how to make a sentence and rules for writing a sentence. Now let us do some exercises based on sentence. Now let us do this exercise. Look at the title of this exercise. Write the following sentences using capital letters and full stop. So in this exercise, what we are going to do? We are going to rewrite these sentences with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. So whenever you write any sentences, we should always start the sentence with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. Now let us rewrite these sentences with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. Look at the first one. Nisha has a pen. Nisha is a naming word. Students, we have to always start the naming words with capital letter. Now let us change the small n to capital N. Now let us write the sentence in the given that Nisha has a pen. Students, now what we have to do? We have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. Students, you should always remember to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. Now let's move on to the next sentence. He is a dancer. So now we have to change the small h to capital H. He is a dancer. Then we have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. What we have to do? We have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. So whenever you write any sentence, you should always start the sentence with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. Look at the next sentence. Dia, Marie and Resma are friends. So whenever you come across two naming words or more than two naming words, you should always write those naming words with the capital letter. So now let us change the small d into capital D, small m to capital M, small r to capital R. Now let us rewrite the sentence in the given dash. Dia, Marie and
exercise. So synthesis exercise, what we have to do, we have to always start the sentence with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. So this is what we have done in this exercise. Now let us move on to the next exercise.
Exercise, look at the group of words below and tick the correct box. So here they have given some groups of words. First we have to find whether the given groups of words is a sentence or not a sentence. If the given group of words is sentence, means we have to put a tick in sentence box. If it is not a sentence, means we have to put a tick in not a sentence box.
Children, look at this exercise. Look at the group of words below and tick the correct box. Again, repeat. Look at the group of words below and tick the correct box. Students, here they have given some groups of words. First, we have to find whether the given groups of words is sentence or not a sentence. If it is sentence, means we have to put a tick in sentence box. If it is not a sentence, means we have to put a tick in not a sentence box. Students, I hope you all know what is sentence. What is sentence? Sentence means a group of words that make complete sense. So when we read these words, definitely we can come to know that whether it is sentence or not a sentence. Look at the first one. Climb the tree. Climb the tree. Students, do you think, does these group of words make any sense? Does this give any meaning? No, it doesn't give any meaning. So where you have to put a tick? Under a sentence or not a sentence? Yes, not a sentence, because these group of words did not give any complete meaning. Now let's move on to the next one. She makes a tasty pizza. Again, Ellie. She makes a tasty pizza. So let's now look at these group of words. All these group of words make any complete meaning? Yes, these group of words make complete meaning. Yes. So of course, definitely this will be a sentence. So where you have to put your tick? Under a sentence or not a sentence? Yes, under a sentence. Look at the next one. Fish lives in water. Fish lives in water. Students, do you think all these group of words give any complete meaning? Yes, these group of words give complete meaning. So these group of words are joined together, that makes a complete meaning is called sentence. So we have to put it under the sentence box. So this is what about this exercise. In this exercise, what we have done, we have just find out whether the given groups of words are sentence or not a sentence. If it is sentence, means we have to put a tick under sentence. If it is not a sentence, means we have to put a tick under not a sentence. Now let's move on to the next exercise. Look at the next exercise. Rearrange the words to make a sentence. Rearrange the words to make a sentence. So here in this exercise, we are going to rearrange these words to make a sentence. We are going to rearrange these words to make a sentence. So here they have given some words in incorrect order. So here we are going to rearrange these words in correct order to make a complete sentence. Students, are you clear what I am saying? Here in this exercise, they have given some words in incorrect order. We have to rearrange those words in correct order to make a sentence. Now, shall we do that? Shall we rearrange these words to make a sentence? Yes. Look at the first one. Place Radha in the ground. Place Radha in the ground. So, since here they have given words in incorrect order. Now, we are going to rearrange these words to make a complete sentence. Students, you all know that sentence has two parts. What are they? One is naming part, another one is telling part. In naming part, you can see naming words. In telling part, you can see what someone or something is doing. So you all know that this telling part always begin with action word. So students, first, so when you write any sentence, the beginning of sentence should be naming word. So here, which one is naming word? Place. Is it naming word? No. Radha. Is it naming word? Yes. Radha is a naming word. So we have to first
relevant as. Students, whenever you write any sentences to make complete sense, first you have to begin the sentence with the naming word or pronouns. So here, first we have to find out the naming word in the given groups of words. So first I have found the naming word. So after finding that, I have written the naming word in the given as Radha. Radha is the naming word. So almost we have completed the naming part. Then students, what we have to write? We have to write the telling part. Students, I told you, telling part always begin with action word. Okay, but students, action word already we have found this answer. So let us. So we have remaining place and in the garden. So among these two words, which one is action word? Do you know that? After writing naming word, we have to write the action word. Which one is action word? Place or in the ground? Which one is action word? Yes, place is the action word. Radha plays. Where does Radha play? In the ground. Where does Radha play? In the ground. Yes. Students, after writing the sentence, what we have to do? We have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. We have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. So this is how we have to rearrange the words to make a complete sense. First, what we have to do? We have to write the naming part, naming word. After writing that, not write telling part. We should always start the telling part with action word. So this is how we have to rearrange the words to make a complete sentence. Alright, so on to the next one. So as I told you, whenever you write any sentences, it should begin with the naming word or pronouns. So here, now let us rearrange these words to make a complete sentence. So in this sentence, in this group of words, which one is pronoun? Go. Is it pronoun?
No.
To school. Is it pronoun?
No.
I. Is it pronoun? Yes. So first, we have to write I. I is a pronoun. So here, this word, this letter I, given in small letter. So you all know that whenever we write any sentences, it should begin with the capital letter. So we should write the small letter into capital letter. We have to change the small letter into capital letter. So I have changed this small letter I into capital I. 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 So now we have written the first part of the sentence. What is the next part? Telling part. In the telling part, what we have to do? We have to write what someone or something is doing. That telling part should begin with the action word. So which one is action word? Already we have written this. So now let us leave that. Now let us write action word. So which one is action word? Go or to school? Go. So we have to write the action word as a second word. I go. Then what we have to write? The remaining part. I go to school. I go. Where do I go? To school. I go. Where do I go? To school. Now we have got the complete sentence. I go to school. I go to school. So what we have to keep at the end of the sentence? Yes, we have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. So this is how we have to do this exercise. For this exam, if you have exercise like this, you just try to do that. Okay students, now let's move on to the next grammar part. Now let us recall them. Doing words from lesson 7. Doing words. So do you all remember what are the doing words? First let us recall the definition for doing words. Look at the board. Doing words tell us what persons, animals or things do. Let me repeat again. Doing words tell us what persons, animals or things do. So doing words is nothing but the words that tell us what someone or something do. So what are the doing words? Doing words that tell us what someone or something do. For example, so what do I do? What I am doing? Yes, I am teaching. I am teaching. Teach. Teach is a doing word. Okay. Now, what I am doing? Yes, I am walking. Walk.
Walk also is a doing verb that I did now. Yes, students. Now what you are doing? Eating, eating, eat. Eat is also a kind of doing verb. Then, students, what you are doing now? Clapping, clap, clap also is a kind of doing verb. Students, what are the doing verbs? Doing verbs is nothing but the verbs that tell us what someone or something do. They are also called as action verbs. They are also called as action verbs. Students, these doing verbs are also called as action verbs. Students, what are the doing verbs? The verbs that tell us what someone or something do. For example, teach, walk. Eat, clap. Again, I tell you the examples. Teach, walk, eat, clap, run. These are the doing verbs that tell us what someone or something do. Okay, students, now let us do one small exercise on doing verbs. Now let us do this exercise based on doing verbs. Look at the title of this exercise. Circle the doing verbs. Circle the doing verbs. Students, here I have written some sentences. First, we have to find out the doing verb in the given sentence. After finding that, we have to circle those doing verbs. Shall we do that? Yes. Look at the first sentence. Reema drives a car. Reema drives a car. Students, in this sentence, which one is doing verb? Can you guess which one is doing verb? Yes. Drives. Drive is a doing verb. Students, after finding that, what we have to do? We have to circle the doing verb. Reema drives a car. Students, who does drive a car? Yes, Reema drives a car. So here the word drives is a doing verb, which is done by Reema. Now let's move on to the next sentence. He sings a song. He sings a song. In this sentence, which one is doing verb? Yes, sings. Sings is a doing verb. So we have to circle this doing verb. He sings a song. Which one is doing verb? Sings. So that's why I have circled this doing verb. Now let us move on to the next sentence. The children shout loudly. The children shout loudly. So which one is doing verb in this sentence? Shout. Shout is a doing verb. So students, what we have to do? We have to circle this word. So who shout loudly? The children. The children shout loudly. Which one is doing verb? Shout. Shout is a doing verb. Now let us move on to the next sentence. They draw a picture. They draw a picture. So which one is doing verb in this sentence? Did you guess? Yes. Draw. Draw. Draw is a doing verb. So we have to circle this doing verb. So this is what we have done in this exercise. We have circled the doing verbs. So this is what are the doing verbs? The verbs that tell us what someone or something do. So this is how you have to do this exercise if they appear in your exam. Okay students, now let us recall the writing part. What is the title of this writing part? Write a few lines about your favorite season. What is the title? Write a few lines about your favorite season. Students, in this writing part, you are going to write about your favorite season. Students, as you all know that there are three major seasons. What are they? Summer, winter and rainy. Among these three seasons, you are going to write about your favorite season. Now let's see what we have to write about our favorite season. Are you ready to do this exercise? Yes. Now I'm going to write about my favorite season. Now, I'm going to write about my favorite season. My favorite season is summer. My favorite season is summer. So now I am going to write about summer season. About which season I am going to write about? I am going to write about my favorite season, summer. What is spelling for summer? S-U-M-M-E-R, summer. Students, in the beginning I told you, know when you do this exercise you should remember to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. Students, when I taught you sentence I told you, know the rule of sentence. What is the rule I have told you? Whenever you write any sentences, you should begin the sentence with the capital letter and end the sentence with full stop. So already in the book itself, we have started the sentences in capital letter. Then what we need to do? We have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. So students, you should remember to keep full stop at the end of each sentences. Students, now about which season we are writing? We are writing about summer season. My favorite season is summer. Look at the next sentence. It comes in the month of Das. It comes in the month of Das. So in this sentence, in this Das, we have to write in which months this summer season will be appear. Students, do you all know in which are the months this summer season will be appear? Do you know that? Yes, summer season will appear in the month of April, May and June. Students, in which month summer season will come? The summer season will be appear in the months of April, May and June. Since almost we have completed the answer for second question. Students, what we have to do after writing the answer? Yes, we have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. Now let's move on to the next sentence. The weather is that. The weather is that. Students, weather means climate. Climate of the season. Students, what weather will come during summer season? What is the climate of summer season? Do you know? Yes, the weather is hot. Hot or warm. Students, what is the climate of summer season? The climate of summer season will be hot or warm. Students, after writing the answer, what we have to do? We have to keep full stop at the end of sentences. Look at the next one. I wear. Students, what do we wear during summer season? We wear cotton clothes. C-O-T-T-O-N. Cotton clothes. C-L-O-T-H-E-S. Cotton clothes. So what we wear during summer season? We wear cotton clothes. Students, after writing the answer, what we have to do? We have to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. So students, always you should remember to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. Now let's move on to the next one. I eat. Students, what do we eat during summer season? What do we eat? We eat an ice cream, juice or soft drinks, and we can also eat some fruits. So students, during summer season I would like to eat an ice cream. So that is what I am going to write on the given das. I eat an ice cream. C-R-E-A-M, cream. I eat an ice cream. So students, after writing the answer, we should remember to keep full stop at the end of the sentence. Students, I eat an ice cream during summer season. Look at the next one. I like
summer. Why do I like? Here you have to write, why do you like summer season? You have to write the reason for why do you like summer season or your any favorite season. So here I have written about my favorite season. My favorite season is summer. So here I have to write the reason. Reason for why do I like summer season. So usually many people like summer season because of its warm weather. Because of its warm weather or vacation. Everybody like vacations. So during vacations, what will we do? We will do some fun outdoor activities. Fun outdoor activities means outdoor games. We like to play outdoor games during vacation. Or else during vacation, we will visit many tour places. So mostly, many people like summer season because of its warm weather and vacations. So I also like summer season because of its warm weather. Warm weather and vacation. That is what I am going to write on the given desk. I like it because of its warm weather. Warm weather. I like it because of its warm weather. W-A-R-M. Warm. Warm means medium heat. I like it because of this warm weather. Weather means a climate and vacation. V-A-C-A-T-I-T-I-O-N. Vacation. So why do I like the summer season? I like summer season because of this warm weather and vacation. So during vacation, we can have lots of fun with our family members, relatives, or friends. So that is why I like the summer season very much. So this is how you have to write about your favorite season in this writing part. So definitely this writing part will be appeared in your exam paper. So be prepared this writing part for your PT4 exam. Let us recall this writing part again. Students, in this writing part, you are going to write about your favorite season. So here I have written about my favorite season. So in the first letter, what you have to write? You have to write the name of your favorite season. So what you have to write in the first letter? You have to write the name of your favorite season. So here I have written my favorite season is summer. Here I have written the name of my favorite season. My favorite season is summer. Look at the next desk. In the next desk, you have to write the names of the month. You have to write names of the month in which your favorite season will be appear. Are you clear? What you have to write in the second desk? You have to write the names of the months in which your favorite season will be appear. Students, here my favorite season will be appear in the month of April, May and June. That's why I have written that in the given desk. Look at the next one. Students, in the next desk, you have to write the climate of your favorite season. You have to write the climate, weather, climate of your favorite season. So my favorite season is, you all know, my favorite season is summer. So the climate of summer season is hot or warm. That's why I have written that in the given dash. Look at the next one. So in the next dash, you have to write which clothes you wear during your favorite season. Which clothes do you wear during your favorite season? So during my favorite season, during summer, I wear cotton clothes. Look at the next one. So in the next desk, you have to write what you like to eat during your favorite season. What you like to eat during your favorite season. So here I have written, during my favorite season summer, I would like to eat an ice cream. That's why I have written that on the given desk. So during summer season, it will be very hot, no? So during that time, we would like to prefer to eat some cold food items. So in that cold food items, I like an ice cream the most. That's why I have written it on the given task. Look at the next one. Students, in the last task, you have to write the reason for why do you like your favorite season. Why do you like your favorite season? You have to write the reason for that. So this is how you have to do this writing.
Dear children, now let us recall the writing part. This writing part is given in lesson 6, Everyday Helpers. Students, this writing part is about birthday invitation. Through this invitation card, you are going to invite your friends. Students, already have taught you this, no? Do you all remember that? In this writing part, what you are going to do? You are going to complete your birthday invitation. Students, in this birthday invitation card, first you have to mention your name. First you have to mention your name. Then you have to mention the birthday date of yours. You have to mention your birthday date. Then you have to mention the time in which you are going to celebrate your birthday party. Then you have to mention the name of the place where you are going to celebrate your birthday party. Students, here you have to mention your home address in the given place. Students, first what you have to do, you have to mention your name. Then you have to mention your birthday date. Then you have to mention the time at what time you are going to celebrate. So you have to mention the time here. Then you have to mention your home address in the given place. Students, this is how you have to do this writing part. Now let us move on to the next writing part. Students, look at this writing part. This writing part is given in your lesson 7, Fino the Little Fish. Students, in this writing part, what we have to do? There will be given a picture of animals or birds. So in this writing part, you are going to write the doing words. So we have to mention what the animals or birds doing in the given picture. So here what we are going to do in this writing part, we are going to write the doing words of the animals. We are going to write what the animals or birds are doing in the given picture. Look at this exercise. The sea animals have a party. Yes, sea animals have a party. What they are doing? They sing and dance. Yes, the words sing and dance are doing words. The octopus plays the drums. Yes. Look at this picture. The octopus plays the drums. Which one is doing what? Plays. The crab plays the guitar. Yes. Where is the crab? Here it is. What the crab is doing? It plays the guitar. The crab plays the guitar. Students, which one is doing what? Plays. Plays is the doing word. The shark dances with dolphin. Students, where is the shark? Yes, here. What shark and dolphin are doing? They are dancing. Dance. Here, which one is doing what? Dance is the doing word. The whale eats chips. Yes, where is the whale? Yes, here it is. What the whale is doing? That is eating the chips. So, which one is doing what? Eat. The turtle and starfish. What they are doing? Turtle and starfish. They play with the ball. What turtle and starfish are doing? They are playing with a ball. The turtle and the starfish play with a ball. So students, which one is doing word? Yes, play is a doing word. Students, this is how you have to do this writing part. So there will be given a picture of animals or birds. We have to write the doing words. So we have to write what the given animals or birds are doing in the picture using doing words. Students, look at this writing part. Students, in this writing part, you are going to write the counting. You are going to count the pictures, then you have to make a sentence. Students, here they have given some toys in the box. We have to count, then we have to write that in a sentence. For example, there is a red ball. Yes, there is a red ball. There are two yellow ducks. Yes, there are two yellow ducks. There are five pink dolls. How many pink dolls are there? There are five pink dolls. So we have to mention there are five pink dolls. There are six blue boats. There are six blue boats. So you have to write that in a sentence like this. You have to count. After counting that, you have to write that in a sentence like this. There are six blue boats. There are seven orange cars. First look at the picture and count the cars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you have to write like this. There are seven orange cars. Look at the next sentence. There are four purple horses. How many purple horses are there? 1, 2, 3, then four. First we have to count, then we have to write that in a sentence like this. There are four purple horses. There are three brown bears. Which means where are the bears? Yes, 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. Now I have counted. After counting that, we have to write the sentence like this. There are three brown bears. There are 8 green pencils. So students, first we have to count the pencil, number of the pencil. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have counted. How many pencils are there? There are 8 pencils. So we have to write that in a sentence like this. There are 8 green pencils. Students, this is how we have to do this writing part. Students, how we have to do? There will be given a pictures in the box or anything else. So first you have to count the number of the picture. After counting that, you have to write that in a sentence like this. Okay students, now let's move on to the next writing part. Children, this writing part, you have this writing part in lesson 9, the mitten. Students, in this writing part, what you have to do? You are going to write about your favorite animal from the play, from the lesson mitten. How many animals are there in this lesson? There are 5 animals. They are bear, fox, rabbit, squirrel, and mouse. So here, what we have to do? Here we have to write the name. Under the name column, you have to write the name of the animals. Under the size column, you have to write the size of the animals. Under the color column, you have to write the color of the given animals. So under the it lives in, under this column, you have to write where does that animal live. Where does that animal live? Students, what is this? Look at this picture. This is bear. So first you have to mention the name of that picture in the given name column, bear. And what is the size of bear? Very big. And what is the color of the bear? Brown. And where does it live? It lives in cave. Look at the next one, fox. You have to write the name of the picture, fox, like this. And what is the size of the fox? Big. And what is the color of the fox? Orange and brown. Orange and brown. Look at this picture. What is the color of the fox? Orange and brown. And where does it live? It lives in a hole under a tree. It lives in a hole under the tree. And what is this? This is a picture of rabbit. So here you have to write the name of the picture, rabbit. And what is the size of the rabbit? Small. And what is the color of the rabbit? White. And where does it live? It lives in a burrow. And look at the next one. Students, what is this? This is a picture of squirrel. Write the name of this picture. The name of this picture is squirrel. What is the size of this picture? Sorry, what is the size of this animal? Very small. It is very small. And what is the color of squirrel? Brown. And where does it live? It lives in a tree. And what is this? This is mouse. This is a picture of mouse. And what is the size? What is the size of a mouse? Tiny, T-I-N-Y, tiny. Students, tiny means very, very small. It is very, very small in size. What is the color of mouse? Gray, gray in color. And where does it live? It lives in hole. Students, after writing like this, you have to write any one of your favorite animal among these animals. So here I am going to write about my favorite animal from this story. My favorite animal is squirrel. Now I am going to write about that. Look at this. My favorite animal from the story is what I said. About which animal I said? Which animal is my favorite? Squirrel. So that's why I have written squirrel. My favorite animal from the story is squirrel. Its size is, what is the size? Very small. You have to write that here. It is very small. Its color. What is its color? Its color is brown. So its color is brown. So this is how you have to write about your favorite animal from the given lesson. First you have to write the name of the animal which is your favorite. Then you have to write its size. Its size is very small. My favorite animal is squirrel. It is very small. Then we have to mention the color. Its color is brown. And I like it because. Students, why do you like it? So here you have to mention the reason for what you like. So here I am going to mention for what I like squirrel. I like it because it is very small and cute. As it looks small, that's why I have liked this squirrel. That's why I have written about squirrel. I like it because it is small and cute. Dear children, all the best for your term 2 exam. Do it well. Thank you, children.